Hello everybody, it's Bjorn Rideau. Coming to you from Wisconsin on the Odinist Riders channel. A few things today. We're going to talk about tribe community and what it may be like to be a part of a focus community. We're also, maybe I'm going to stop and do a video for Project Noble. I've decided to change a few things on that and how things are done for a few reasons, and I'll explain that later if we get to do it. I was actually going to go out fishing today, but unfortunately I can't afford the fishing license if I want to eat and take a ride today, because it's going to be about 70 degrees. And I said I'd bring a vlog today, so here we are. I haven't used the mic in a while, so I hope it's going strong. I'll review the video before I come back. That way maybe I can make some adjustments if it's all shitty. So, discussions about communities came up in the chat room as always. Some recent event. Political, social, demographic. It's always one of those things or another. So, and I'd like to talk today about Odinist communities, focus communities, however you want to identify as such. They are not impossible. In fact, there's some out there already. They take a lot of time to build. There is a very heavy, some of them have very heavy vetting processes. Others are a little easier than others. And the subject came up about the world dollar and currency. Now in a small village, if you manage to get things going, eventually you could make your own village currency, barter and trade items. But you'd still have to go out into the real world and make some money to help with the land tax and whatever other expense, say equipment, you need to help maintain the land. And that's where Odinism comes into the modern world as well. You can farm like an ancient technique. You can do all that if you want to. But if you could have a machine and have a field done within a day, why not get the machine if possible? Currency could be whatever too. You know, it could be oil or gas or that machinery for trade of something else, food and goods that you grow. But not everybody out in the world is going to trade with you. Especially since green paper is the biggest extent of currency in the world. And if it wasn't green paper, it'd be something else. It'd be a fucking rock or something. I hope you don't mind my language too much. This is a very unscripted and uncensored channel. I do speak my thoughts quite a bit. And I have to constantly watch my mirrors because people drive like assholes out here. Especially going out into the countryside like we're going to today. I may stop at one of my favorite spots and take a walk back in. Sit for a little bit and talk. It is spring and the walleye are running, so there's going to be people out everywhere. We're going to stop by and maybe see if we can't see some sturgeon spawning. Some true engineering of the gods, you could say. Mother Nature herself. I mean, right now I'm just out on my way to a farm, and I won't be able to record any of that because it's somebody else's property. I'm going to go help out a little bit. But we'll talk more about that later, possibly. So, anyways, community vetting processes. Now, some kindreds require DNA testing, and those of you that have been around a while will probably know which ones they are. Which I can entirely understand that. I wouldn't want an undesirable in my kindred. That also leads to your internal struggles with a kindred as well, because you can have to lay down certain laws and rules for your country's laws. And like it or not, that's just how it is. So you got to keep all these things in mind when you are trying to build. Just due to the fact that things always change, and you got to kind of evolve with the times, and you got to not compromise your values and your ways. Because I've done that myself, and the outcome was never good. It's like right now, a lot of my relatives are pissed off at me because I won't compromise on certain things. In fact, I am in the process of separating myself entirely from them, just due to all the bullshit and mess that has been going on. I've been watching most of the younger generation now go down the tubes because of all this crap. And it's really affected the family life, and I just don't want any part of it anymore. I tried my damnedest to keep my family together. But they basically have no desire. So that's another thing about a focused community, is you can have that desire, you can keep your words, you can keep your oaths, and not compromise your values. Like I said, it takes a lot of time, a lot of vetting, and a lot of effort to build such societies, because they're considered fringe on modern society, or what you would call modern. You know, they're considered taboo. Even though some of the things you look at in today's society and you're like, what the fuck are they doing? And typically, we try to leave everybody alone until everyone's sticking their nose in our business. Then, okay, we're going to kind of retaliate and push back. And that's when people get nasty. That's when, say, you're violating my civil rights and yada, 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 yada. But usually something that comes on like that, people don't realize is that they're the ones who push first. When I've seen a lot of the Odinist or Folkish heathens keep to themselves, they don't care until they are tread upon. And then they take matters into their own hands, most of them anyway, or sometimes they have to let local law enforcement deal with it. Because it's a drastic situation. And not a lot of people have that time to sit in jail because they got to take care of their families. So look at this. Talk about today. When I think of the other thing, I'll start again. And like I said before, if you are an independent artist of the Folkish European ways, and you have music you want to get out there, drop me a line, hit me up on a message, or leave a comment. Like and subscribe, please, too. Help me grow a little bit here, and I'll help you grow. I mean, some of the music I've already used is, I guess you could say, a bit more political, but hey, whatever works, right? The last song I used was Snow Fell, and it was sung by Stefan Kraft. So if you got a cover song, or maybe you got something original, let me know. I'll use more focused music that's traditional. I'll use whatever else too. If you got a blog, or you make videos yourself, I'll put a link into the channel. Or if you have art, please put a watermark on it so they know it's yours, because people will all use it. And I'll also put it on my channel, as long as you got a watermark on it. Give you proper credit for it. Even editing my blog post, some people like to edit because it didn't make sense, and I'm thankful for that. I give them credit for it too. The blog is the focus state. It's probably going to slow down a bit. Doing the videos will pick back up in the colder months, because I'm out on my bike a lot. I mean, right now I gotta put a new tire and do an oil change on this thing. But that will be like a sitting garage talk vlog. And the reason for that, I'll wait until it rains to do that. And we got rain coming up. And I've been working some overtime, so hopefully it'll come up next weekend. I do a lot of traveling around with other people too, and they don't like being on camera, so, you know, I gotta respond with their wishes. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video, and when I think of some of the other subjects I wanted to talk about, I'll turn my camera back on and we'll do. I'm getting near my destination, so I will talk to you guys later. Stay true to your ancestors, stay true to the gods, and don't let them get you down. Keep going, must be the camera. Alright guys, we're back, and basically right now I'm scouting out fishing holes, and then we might head up to a town called Shiocton and see if we can find any sturgeon. See any, but here in the state of Wisconsin they're heavily protected. The only time you can actually take them is during the spearing season, but I don't know why you'd eat a fish that's probably over 100 years old and 6 foot long. That's beyond me.
Now, like I said, the wall
air running, I'm gonna miss it this year, but I'd rather eat for a week instead of just a few days on what I catch. And that's even if I catch anything. I've never really had much of luck with walleye. Better luck with trout. But those streams are so few and far between here, you have to travel extensively to find them. And economically, that would bring me back to community with oak-focused heathens. Because not only would you have to supplement your income, you'd have to make your own currency, possibly eventually, to try to cut yourself off from the outside world as much as possible, because at your community, but you'd have to learn to stock food through the three seasons before you could actually become somewhat self-sufficient.
And I say somewhat
because it doesn't always happen like that. Oh yes, boats galore on the river today. Prepper for a short period of time, so all my relatives kept eating all my food and laughing at me. You know, conspiracy theorists, which a lot of these conspiracies nowadays just come to light. They just come in different forms, many different forms. And yeah, so if you're a prepper, you know what I'm talking about, but all Odinists to some degree should be preppers. Prepare for incoming winters, you need to prepare for economic hardships. Trust me, those times come, and sometimes they're few and far between, sometimes they're a lot more. But so the river next to us right now is the Wolf River, and it's named for obvious reasons. There are a lot of wolves around in Wisconsin. And they've been a real menace as of late. And I think they're about to lift the ban for hunting. First season on them. They did about 2 years ago. They thinned them out. Everything kind of went back to normal, which I'm all for keeping the cycle of life in balance, because we humans, believe it or not, are still part of that cycle. No matter how much you hate to shoot something that looks like a dog, which, trust me, they are far from a dog. If you've ever actually seen a wolf, you know what I'm talking about. They are the feral and primal ancestor and descendants of dogs. The only reason I say descendants is because they're still around, and that bloodline has kept going. So, I mean, I went hunting last year, and all I found was wolf track and gut piles. Of course, you kind of hunt them, so, you know. So, like I said, turkey season's coming up in Wisconsin, and this is the big, one of the biggest tourist tracks they got. Because fishing, hunting, a lot of water sports, believe it or not. They compete with everything, and surprisingly, there's not a lot of people on the docks from the looks of things. There's a lot of people out on the water with boats, but I kind of wish I had my fishing license. And for those of you guys saying, I don't ask the king permission to hunt, well, when the king can take all your shit, like your vehicle and some of your property, because you broke some law, yeah, you're probably better off paying the $20. It is tyrannical law, yes, I know. I've heard every story, excuse, and everything in the book. Yesterday, I met a gentleman who was just the same. I'm like, yep. But, I mean, the DNR around here, which is our basically Environmental Protection Agency, they do a pretty good job at keeping things up, keeping things the way they should be. A lot better than those dickheads I know back east. They dump like fucking rattlesnakes and expect them to take care of the rodent population. Well, they do, then they den up and breed, then they dump more turkeys and vultures in, expecting them to eat the snakes. Well, that didn't go so well. That actually had the opposite effect. They were eating more other stuff than they were anything else. I've actually been fishing out here, now that I remember, and really didn't have any luck. Man, that river's up. So there's a small section of road here I'm looking for, and it's where the river kind of crosses over. So we might backtrack a little, you never know. This is supposedly all reserve land too. Looks like a lot of small base community. But I'm going to try to do the talking head vlog today, sitting on the docks, see how that works. To Shiocton, which a lot of my Native American names, so I'm pretty much going to butcher some of it. Sturgeon Trail Parking. If we don't find the road I'm looking for, we may see some sturgeon. It's kind of early yet, and I haven't heard much about the spawning. But if you've never seen sturgeon before, when you see one that's about 8 to 6 feet long, and you're just like, oh man, that thing's humongous. It's amazing. So I'm kind of glad I got out today too. I actually have more money today than I have had previous weeks. So I'm kind of happy everything's kind of like evening out finally. But you have your good days and your bad days and your shit weeks and your good weeks. Might be our, that's a parking area. Guys, until I get to the talking head point, which hopefully it's around here somewhere, I'm going to have to stop and pull out my phone. As much as people hate technology nowadays, it does come in handy. Not going to lie about it. This might be it right here. Yep, Driftwood Road, this is it. Or drive, whatever. Road, drive, dead end. Usually when I go somewhere too, I try to bring back a piece of wood and kind of capture that spiritual energy. That way I can carve something into it, which I haven't done any carving lately. So for those of you that knew I was working on a god bowl of tear, I haven't really done very much to it, so you're not missing much. I just got to make sure this isn't somebody's property back here, which it looks like it is. So maybe no talking head point today unless I go to my usual spot. Public hunting and fishing grounds. It's in that realm, but I didn't know there were houses back here. So the river's on the other side of the houses. Somebody's land. I'm not bothering that. Sorry. Well, I'm going to set up for Shagocton, and from there, if we can get to one of my favorite spots too, that'd be easy. Hopefully there's nobody around so I can do a head vlog there. Stay tuned.